Thanks for staying with Morning Live. Now, today, Johannesburg Mayor Herman Mashaba is having his last day in office, and he resigned after Helen Zille was elected DA Federal Council Chairperson. So, what's next for Herman Mashaba? He's here to tell us a little bit more about his time in office and, of course, where to from here. Thanks so much for coming through.
Thank you so much, Sakina. It's been an absolute pleasure the last 3 years of our engagement. Obviously, I've been engaging with the SABC for the last 35 years, but obviously the last 3 years as a public servant. And I think you, as a SABC, has really given us a fair objective analysis of what was happening in Johannesburg, and I truly appreciate it, and I would really wish everything of the best for the new leadership that's going to be elected tomorrow.
And how would you assess your time in office? When you came in, many people were skeptical, you know, not quite sure whether someone, as they would say, with a lack of political experience would be able to handle this job, being the executive mayor of the economic hub of this country. How would you assess your time?
I think if I look at it in reflection to my the lack of what is supposedly called political experience, I think that's what helped me. Because if you really look at the so-called experienced politicians, how they've messed up our country is in big, big trouble today. You look at all the indicators. IMF just 2 days ago expressed very serious concern about South Africa. I'm sure, Kina, you've got family, friends, fellow South Africans, young ones who are denied an opportunity to get good education. 10.2 million of our people are unemployed today with no dignity of work. 60% of the black youth are today without work. 18 million South Africans today, to put bread on the table, they have to rely on social grants. And you can imagine what social grants do to you as a human being. Takes away your dignity. We have the country with borderless counterfeit goods, billions of counterfeit goods are coming into our country, not just really apparel. I think this counterfeit goods matter, we need to fight the South Africans and head on, because these criminal syndicates are already bringing in medication, they are bringing in food. That the other day, talking to some of the inspectors, saying, Mayor, please just talk to our government, otherwise a few years down the line, we'll have a health catastrophe. So these are some of the challenges that that we are facing. The city of Johannesburg attracts 3,000 people every month. Because we're not building affordable accommodation fast enough, but at the same time, with the economy collapsing in the rural areas, urbanization becomes a huge challenge. And urbanization, it's an international phenomenon. It just needs political leadership that can have the foresight to plan in advance. But with us in South Africa, we've dismally failed. I mean, last night, I remember we are coming back from a function with JMPD. I see our people sleeping out in the streets. And my wife and I, my wife said, but what happens to these people during rainy days? You know, thousands literally everywhere. And these numbers, it is the number. Mm. It's the number that is increasing every day. So we've got new challenges. And I think all of us as South Africans, if we are going to allow this trajectory to continue, this country will collapse.
So just to quote you from a few seconds ago, you say, we as South Africans, we've dismally failed. Have you failed as mayor?
Absolutely.
Of Johannesburg?
I think all of
let's talk to the mayor. Indicators.
No, yeah.
Not nationally, but to the city of Johannesburg.
I think fortunately
let's
now,
speak to those.
Fortunate enough, I think as a city of Johannesburg, if I look at when we took over this, the government, remember I did a study of our infrastructure backlog, 170 billion rands, aging roads, infrastructure, our water reticulation systems, and everything. And we've now moved our infrastructure backlog from, and we took over from 58% to 71%. If you look at our service delivery on major projects, big substations, say Benza One as an example, the biggest in Southern Hemisphere, 1.2 billion rands, we delivered it 50 million rands below the budget. We've opened and refurbished another six substations. The We've insourced, given dignity to 7,000 of our fellow residents who were exploited by hyenas and so-called tenderpreneurs. The city has insourced them. Some of them doubled their pay. Some of them given them 50% with a pension. Now 7,000 families, they've got a dignity of a proper job. Beautiful. 8,000 families given title deeds to their homes. You remember us as black people prior to 1994, we were not allowed to own property in Johannesburg. When we passed our constitution in 1996, the constitution empowered municipalities as a matter of agency to give black people title to their properties. We've given already just over 8,000 title deeds. The number more than double what the previous administration issued in 22 years.
I must just indicate that I think it's in poor taste for political parties to use that as, you know, some sort of political football, because why aren't people given those title deeds when they enter those properties? Because if you're saying you're building these houses for poor and indigent people, why should it be almost a favor for you to hand them the title deed
In fact, such a very, very important question you're asking. You ask yourself, you can check on our records. Hardly 2 months in office, I was already giving out title deeds. And the process of eventually issuing out the title deeds is something that takes a couple of months. Now you ask yourself, why were title deeds not given to our people? The ones that Herman Mashaba and the new multi-party government started issuing. Yes, majority of them, we processed them ourselves. We put fast track. But there were already thousands of title deeds which were lying in government, not being issued to our people. And that's a question that, honestly, I cannot really answer. But one thing I can confirm, that the thousands of title deeds were already prepared but not given to our people. Why? I think that question, can it be please be referred to the previous administration?
I think we'll have a separate discussion on that, because, you know, I want to touch on quite a few issues with you. With regard to the state of the city, what did you find and what are you leaving as per the city's liquidity position?
Well, fortunate enough, the last 2 months, we started with National Treasury giving excellent performance of the city of Johannesburg, how the city's finances has improved. 2 weeks ago, we had Moody's coming out with exactly the same report. Yesterday, I had an excellent meeting with a team from the Auditor General in terms of the city's financial situation being in a healthy and improved the environment. Remember when I took over the government, where corruption was the order of the day, the city of Johannesburg was free for all. To stabilize this was one of the biggest challenges, with senior officials, majority of them being deployed to cadres who were not really prepared to work with us. And to stabilize this really took time. Remember, I was accused of paging people.
Yes.
People who were not prepared to work for government, prepared to work for political parties, sabotagers. And getting rid of them was not an easy exercise. And I got rid of them, and I don't apologize to anyone about it, because these are people who were prepared to sabotage government, and not realizing that by sabotaging my administration, they're sabotaging our people. But fortunate enough, three agencies, National Treasury, please ask National Treasury, but it is there on their website. You can look at the health of the city of Johannesburg. You can look at the statement from Moody's. And the Auditor General one, obviously, they're still doing the final numbers, but I can assure you the health of the city of Johannesburg, it's in a much better position than ever before.
So the Alexandra Renewal Project, we know the Public Protector's Office and the Human Rights Commission here in Gauteng, they are beset with that particular issue. And there's a lot of talk about what actually went on there. And it speaks to, once again, the corruption that the city has had to deal with. What is your assessment of that situation? What did you find? Was any money allocated and spent on the Alexandra Renewal
Project? It's a very, very sad state of affairs. It's actually quite embarrassing for us as South Africans to have subjected people of Alexandra to that chaos, to that deplorable living conditions. You remember very well President Thabo Mbeki, 2006, when he launched the Alexandra Renewal Project in Parliament. June 2016, before the elections, the ANC had a big party in Alexandra signing an MOU. I'm sure you must have said side of that MOU, promising people of Alexandra taking Alexandra to the next level. Alexandra, fortunate enough, I've always had family there. From the time I was born, used to go there. People using the toilets that had the municipality collecting every month. But I look at Alexandra then and now, it's a shame 25 years into our democracy when government at the national level committed the renewal of Alexandra and it is still
alive. So what happened? It's really very unfortunate. Was there money allocated? And was there any money spent? You have access to the books. You've had
more especially that I'm leaving office, our group forensic and investigation officers has done a sterling job. I know the Human Rights Commission, we made, as a city of Johannesburg, made our contribution to the Human Rights Commission. I'm not sure if they've had any interaction with the public protector, but the information is available. I think let us allow
money
that.
Allocated and
I think I would really like that not to be the one actually releasing this, because I did not do the investigation myself. I'm not a professional forensic investigator. Our group forensic the unit in the city of Johannesburg did a thorough work and are very, very concerned about what really around what really transpired.
People are they listen to you. You're the mayor of the city of Johannesburg.
But it doesn't really mean that if you're a mayor, you must go around making irresponsible statements. I'm saying is there's an official
unit. But I'm not asking you to be irresponsible. I'm simply asking you to tell us what the situation is.
I'm saying to people of Alexandra and people of South Africa that group forensic department, that is why they even requested the presentations to be done in camera, because of their consent with what already transpired. This must just give you an indication that as the city of Johannesburg, we are already concerned with really what transpired in Alexandra.
And leaving office today, you obviously came in as a mayor under the DA banner, and you left the DA because of Helen Zille's ascension once again in some of the upper structures of the party. Why? You joined the party under her tenure.
I joined the party because I was concerned with the direction the ANC was taking our country. And I looked at all the opposition parties and I thought D and I share the same passion to build a One South Africa for All. And discovered in the process, as soon as I took over the administration, literally from day one, that the D and I don't really share the same passion of building One South Africa for All, particularly when it comes to providing services to poor areas. And fortunate enough, I was really very fortunate in the sense that I was elected by a multi-party government and I wasn't beholden to one political party. And I was not prepared to negotiate to give our poor people the dignity. And what I find actually quite unacceptable, because as much as the political party itself not happy with directing resources to poor communities, I would go into the suburban areas and the residents in these areas, every time I shared what is happening in our city, they'd always say, "Mashaba, please, we can deal with a pothole or a street light not working or our grass not cut. Please go and give our fellow South Africans the dignity." But I had really conflict with the party that really felt, no, I must go and cut grass with the little budget that I had. And I told that to them, if that's the case, you can really keep your party. I'll move on.
So where to from here for Herman Mashaba?
Herman Mashaba had a brutal 3 years, but extremely rewarding. Herman Mashaba is ready to go and leave for 2 months or so, just go and reflect, to go and play a little bit of golf that never had a chance to play for a long time, go and read books that that I never had a chance to read the last the few months. However, what I'm excited about 2-3 weeks ago, I actually thought to him, while you're on holiday, one thing is that you are concerned about the future of South Africa. Please arrange to really create a platform where South Africans can actually look at themselves in the mirror. So in a week or two, I'll be launching a huge platform to give South Africans an opportunity to look at themselves in the mirror, to decide and debate, engage on the type of South Africa that they want. Because one thing that is without question is that the politicians prior to 1994 during CODESA, they negotiated a good deal for themselves. Because one thing for sure, South Africa has been exceptionally good for politicians, but a nightmare for residents. And I'm saying, no, we've got to have a second CODESA. And I'd really like to really be the one driving that process of getting civil society to participate in this process. And I'll be launching this platform in another week or so. It will be great. And within the next 3 months or so, I will release scientific evidence of how people of South Africa feel about the country and where they'd like to take it. And then I'll leave it to South Africans to decide for themselves.
Herman Mashaba, thank you so much and wishing you well in your future endeavors.
Thank you so much for this great opportunity.
And that was outgoing Mayor of Johannesburg, Herman Mashaba. Thanks to him for chatting to us as he leaves office today. At 7:30.